Thanks for joining me today to learn a little bit more about when and who developed COBie. Bill Broad at NASA initiated the project and brought the Army Corps of Engineers Engineering Research and Development Center into the project. The Facility Maintenance and Operations Committee of the National Institute of Building Sciences was also seen as a great place to take the project, since the results would need to be widely distributed throughout the entire construction and design industries. The COBie specification was developed based on industry best practices and an extensive literature review. All of this can be found in the June 2007 initial publication of the COBie specification. The findings of the report were very straightforward. In order to reproduce an electronic version of the current paper handover documents, three types of information would be needed: information about maintenance, information about facility operations, and information about facility assets. Those requirements were then organized into three specific projects: COBie, dealing with the assets in the building; SPI, dealing with the standards and properties about that equipment that would be provided by manufacturers; and the equipment layout information exchange, which would include information about the HVAC, the electrical, the water, the control systems, and other systems. Both COBie and SPI are currently ongoing projects. The ELIE or ELIE project is now developed into an HVAC specification, a water system specification, an electrical system specification, and a building automation management information exchange specification. It's all well and good that a very nice model of managed and maintained asset, performance data, and equipment layout information was developed. It's quite another thing to take those data models and have them be part of actual design and construction contracts. That's why all of these projects were developed with the letters IE at the end. IE stands for Information Exchange, and it's really a shorthand for Contracted Information Exchange. The next study we did looked at what kinds of things needed to be changed about the specification in order to apply it to a specific instance of a project, and we really found there were three kinds of information that needed to be changed. The first customization required to the spec is to figure out what assets an owner wants to manage or maintain. The second is how that information is going to be consumed once it's received. And lastly, what is the level of detail of the information that needs to be delivered? Between 2006 and 2009, the organizations identified in this list joined the program. Some of these organizations participated in the development of COBie as part of the United States National BIM Standard, version 2, published in March of 2012. The Engineer Research and Development Center developed a commentary that would go with the standard called the COBie Guide and a draft set of construction contract specifications as a performance-based information exchange. To further work on the COBie specification and to look at how this information about building assets could be reused for different situations, several consulting firms and university departments joined the team. The following slides give an overview of some of those projects. An important aspect of any standard is that there be yardsticks against which deliverables for that standard can be tested. Today, these models are used in the production of standards. Notably, the medical clinic contains redacted drawings, redacted O&M manuals, as well as a full set of building information models for all of the IE standards. The COBie Responsibility Matrix, one of the first technical documents developed for COBie, allows project teams to identify responsibility for specific elements within a COBie dataset, demonstrates the mapping between IFC and spreadsheet versions of COBie data, identifies the IFC filtering list for those people that are using the IFC coordination view, and a supplemental document gave guidelines for merging models when models from various disciplines needed to be included with the architectural model. Whether you use the STEP physical file format, the IFC XML, spreadsheet XML, or COBie Lite specification, the standard data model developed to express what COBie information is required is contained in the IFC COBie model view definition. That can be found from a link on the COBie webpage. While much of the focus of COBie has been on the major exchanges of information that accompany paper drawings, one of the studies conducted by the group looked at where that information comes from. Specifically, we were interested in capturing the individual transactions that developed each piece of COBie data over time. Ultimately, that's how we get COBie data on your iPhone and your Android tablets. One of the perennial questions about COBie, what is its cost and what are its benefits, is answered in this report. We were also able to evaluate how COBie data could directly support the production of lead datasheets. Another project in the sustainability vein defined the attributes that needed to be added to a COBie file in order to predict the electricity and water usage of the building once it was completed. Along with all of these projects, commercial software began to be tested, starting in July of 2008 at the National Academy of Engineers, through EchoBuild, NF-MNT, and finally Building Innovations. COBie is now part of over 30 commercial software systems. Here's a timeline that'll give you a general idea of the software that has adopted COBie to date. All of the publicly available testing done by the Building Smart Alliance can be found on the Building Smart Alliance Means and Methods page. An internet search might even show you there's many other that claim COBie compatibility, although they have not yet been tested by the Building Smart Alliance. So, thanks for joining me today. I hope that this video has answered some questions about when COBie was developed and who did it.